I'm going to Laos for the first time. My mum's from Laos and I've never been back. The best part about it is that my little niece Taya's coming and my whole family's coming with me. I've got two older brothers and one younger. Try and tell you who's the one to look out for, but to be honest, you need to look out for all of them. You know, we're essentially four best mates going back to my mum's country to see what it's all about.
Can I get a little picture of it?
On the way up to Laos, we get to stop over and spend a day in Singapore, which we're all really excited about. You know, it's a place that none of us have been to, and probably quite the opposite of Laos. I've had my mum, you know, tell me a little bit about Laos, and I've asked her a few stories along the way, but...
My mum and dad split up probably when I was about 13, and then mainly just with dad up until... mid-20s and just catch up with mum every now and then.
I guess the strongest connections with mum was Shaun and I. Joe and Adam, you know, I guess they still carried like a bit of pain in their heart from not having mum there. But then at the same time it was, you know, we understood that mum was on her own, so we'd always visit mum and make sure that she was all right.
Dad, he didn't help raise us, he did raise us, so for him to come away on this trip and take a step back while we learn about, you know, mum's side, yeah, I think that, you know, probably credit to him, really. You know, as you get older, it probably gets harder to put these sorts of things together, so, you know, it's a once-in-a-lifetime trip for us to go back and learn about our culture and see what created the person that is my mum, and, you know, we won't get another chance to do it. You know, we generally don't know what to expect, so it's going to be a fun ride. Finally made it to Laos. Coming through the airport, immediately met a cousin.
Hey, thank you very much, cousin. That's my cousin.
It's a pretty surreal feeling, you know, to be honest.
Hey guys, sabadee, how are you? Shaun, nice to meet you.
Came out to a very nice welcome from the people from Laos Rugby, who are actually going to be hosting us in a couple of days.
Hey. Oh, thank you. That's my older brother, Tope.
We're all going through the exact same thing, you know, where it's like, are we really here right now? Looking out the window going, that's Laos. You know, we're in Viet Chung, that's Laos right there. Seeing people on their scooters, no helmets, kids on the scooters. Look at this.
Hello.
Like, no helmet, man. It's just so wicked to be here.
Somebody.
Yes. I've always said that to my mum growing up, eh? Never. Now I'm saying it in Laos, how cool is that?
We've grown up with mum in NZ, and mum's had no family. You know, no cousins, no sisters, no uncles, no aunties, nothing. So the only family that she's had is pretty much us.
For our first night in Laos, we're going to see my mum's other sister, who... I'm not too sure what she's putting on for us, but I understand it's just a little bit of food.
The hug that they gave us was really welcoming, you know, like it, you just felt like it was a really genuine hug and there was a lot of warmth behind it.
Of all her sisters, that was the only one that had met me when I was 3 months old. You know, to see the look on that sister's face and to say my name, and you know, to say my name as if it's someone that had met me before that I had never met. Yeah, it was unreal.
Yeah,
sorry, listen to like them talk. It was pretty crazy. Obviously, growing up, I couldn't even tell you how many sisters she had. So it was like nothing had changed. It was exactly like me and my brothers. And as soon as they got there, they were laughing and singing. And yeah, it was pretty cool to see.
Mum,
with the bracelets, you know how you do it on us at home. What's it like? Did you say that you only do it on like occasions, special?
Yeah.
So what?
When you come visit her,
yeah.
You first time come into Laos, she had to do our Black.
So it's because it's our first time here, she's just sort of blessing the trip type thing. Yeah, look, we've had, you know, the bands put on our wrist by our mum a few times back home. Us coming to Laos for the first time, coming to our auntie's house. It was a pretty special moment, you know, to be there doing it with my brothers as well.
Thank you. Thank you.
Sticky rice. We weren't really sure what to expect, you know, coming here, and, you know, Mum made it very clear that, you know, none of her family are, you know, very well off, so to come in and see the spread they've put on with a lot of love in it, and certainly felt it, you know, as soon as we stepped foot through that door, so. Mum, she's always told us, you know, growing up, that her and her family are very close, and I, to be honest, I always sort of thought, well, how can you be if you've moved away from them, you know, and you're not with them? But honestly, seeing her here with them right now has justified everything I've ever heard from her. So they're just cracking up. They're pretty much like the four girl versions of me and my brothers, you know. So seeing her happy, seeing her smile, it's definitely made this trip already worth it.
Thank you very much for having us. Thank you, thank you. Oh, cup jai, cup jai. Cup jai.
Being our first day in Laos, Mum wanted to bless us, you know, for our trip in Laos. This is my mum's Buddha. When I wanted to get the tattoo, she made it very clear that I couldn't just go and get anyone, and she actually gave me her one in person. So I took that to the artist, and lucky the artist that did it was a real spiritual sort of dude and really understood. So it's a funny conception, everyone just thinks a Buddha's a Buddha, but yeah, we learned pretty quickly that they've all got their own one that they pray to. We were probably most nervous about not being disrespectful and not mucking things up. You know, our understanding of, I guess, being Buddhist isn't as high, you know, as probably what it should be. And a part of us coming here today is to get that understanding and learning.
Yeah, we go out that way.
We've all had different relationships with Mum, and, you know, I've always been the one asking all the questions, and even when we're home, always sort of wanting to learn, and I'd call her a bit, and we'd always just talk about anything and everything.
Yeah, it was different. Obviously, growing up with Dad, it's something that I'd never experienced, and you can tell how much they believe. And yeah, it's not so much them preaching to you or saying, you know, this is what you have to do. It's more them just saying, keep safe on your travels, and it's good to see you and meet you and all that.
For me, the meaning comes from just thinking that this means so much to Mum. It's beautiful, you know, it really is.
Well, for me, I've always, you know, I say I'm a man of the universe, so it's all about the love, eh, at the end of the day. And for me, it's, if someone's gonna give you a blessing, bless something good upon you, and you take that blessing, eh, you know? It's easy for someone to throw hate at you. If someone's gonna bestow something good on you, man, you know, run with it.
Let's go have some delicious food. It doesn't look like much from the road, but she said it's the best pho, which is a family favourite, that you'll find, so let's give it a go. It smells mean already. This is, it's a good sign. Hey?
The only other place I've experienced pho like that is at my mum's. And usually I won't eat pho anywhere else, you know, because to me, Mum makes the best pho, so.
Had a few people, like, when I put up a photo of it, when Mum made it for us at home, I'd put it up and spelt it F-U-R, you know, just sort of how it sounded. And then there was a few Lao people coming on, it's actually P-H-O. Yeah, and we're like, oh, okay.
Yeah, we've only ever been exposed to our mum's cooking back home. And when Mum cooks pho, it's just on point, it's phenomenal. But we've got nothing to compare it to.
This is, you put some of this in, Mum?
Yeah, I do, but.
Yeah.
not until coming over here and experiencing pho in a little restaurant off the street in a side street of Laos, and it tastes exactly the same. You know that mum's cooking's on point.
What's this place called? Tad Nyang. So me and Dad have come out to Tad Nyang Waterfall. We're on the border of Pak Song, I'm pretty sure. So we're in between sort of Pak San and Pak Song. We've heard about this awesome spot here and yeah, decided to come along and check it out. When you hooked up with Mum back in the day.
Back in the day,
I'm talking like way back in the day.
Yeah.
Since you just turned 53 the other day.
Yeah.
It is literally way back in the day now.
It is, yeah.
Did you think that this is where she came from? Did you think this is what it was going to be like?
I didn't know too much about the country, but I knew it was near Thailand. I knew what Thailand was about. So Vietnam, Thailand, Cambodia, I knew it was all around that same sort of culture.
Being over here with all of us, and in particular, you know, for Mum and learning all about Mum, Dad sort of had to take a back seat, so to be able to spend some time with him, I know he really likes this sort of stuff, so it's been good.
Geez, you couldn't come down here when it's raining.
You're asking, my brother's dad has been our rock, you know, our whole lives. He raised us four boys on his own, and he's always been, I guess, there for us, but at the same time, always wanting us to have a relationship with Mum, and hence why he's here, you know, visiting Laos, you know, with all of us, because he's always looked at this as a big part of our lives.
That's pretty awesome.
Holy. He worked whenever he could, dropped us off to school every day, picked us up every day, even if he was a little late at times. He was driving all of us who played sport all across town, different directions. Where we grew up, Whangaparoa, it was out of the city, so he was taking us 50 minutes, an hour, you know, on Saturday mornings at times to get us to our footy games. He still brought us up to be the people we are today, and he's a pretty good dude.
Right, hill sprints.
He's not funny, man. He's so dry. Can you get a shot of that? Get a shot of that real quick. Like, I just don't feel like we need to feed him that sort of stuff. So he's a good dad. He's a really good dad, but he's up there. Going to a Lao Rugby Day. We're out here, received an invite from Lao Rugby to come down and participate in a day where there's going to be apparently a heap of kids. Somebody. They somehow know me. I was surprised. I actually asked them that. I go, so do you guys actually even know me, or was this sort of forced on you? But no, they made it pretty clear that, yeah, I'm a superstar here, so I'll take that. Sabadi. Koi hak jiao.
So they're learning some steps here.
Oh, okay, that's good.
Yeah, long
We heard the little boys over here stepping, and a couple of them got me pretty clean. Hey. Eyes. Tell them to use their eyes. Yeah, yeah, and then, yeah, there you go. He's a prop. He just runs straight. That's too many. Step.
There it is. Yeah, falling with the eyes.
Oh, man, okay, okay.
I need help, I need help.
First drill I went to over there, they switched on very fast.
Jogging, jogging, turn, pass through. Good? Okay, you guys have a go.
Yeah. Reminds me of my brother, that one there. I think these guys are doing a terrific job, you know, of getting them in shape. And look at this, getting their skills up. So it's cool just to come in and hang out.
Are we racing? Oh, you, no, you guys don't speak English, do you?
Go, go, go! So humbling, you know it is. It's really, really cool. It's really nice. I mean, this is the sort of stuff I love doing back home. So to be able to do it and come over here and be recognised by some of the kids here, it is. It's really humbling, really special. So yeah, I've loved it.
There you go, man.
Yeah, you got to get a shot of these fellas. They're signing autographs and everything, these guys. So I think they're lapping it up as well.
I can't do this. It's all about spreading the love.
Today is Lao National Day, and you know, it's a celebration for the Lao people, but you know, for our family, and you know, part of coming back to Laos, you know, there's a little bit more to it, and I guess a little bit more meaning, you know, I guess on this day for our family.
All the water, everything, and they got the small boat, you know, behind the small boat, everything, you know.
Today marks the day that my mum left this country 36 years ago.
I don't have my clothes, yeah. Only one bag, you know.
What, not a nice handbag like this? It wasn't your Gucci handbag, you didn't pack with you.
When we thought about going to the spot and we spoke about, you know, going to do it today, Mum was pretty undercover with keeping it to herself that it was literally on this day 36 years ago she crossed the spot that we're going to go and visit.
So all the water was in here?
Yeah.
And then that side is Thai.
Is that Thailand over there?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh. It's changed a bit since she was last there, but just to be in that space and knowing what she went through that day to, I guess, leave this country, pretty special moment for us.
I went and then I never looked back because I said, I know that if I go back, I get in jail. If I'm not cool, you know, die or go.
When she left Laos, there was a lot going on with the government and things were changing and pretty much she escaped. And, you know, she tells the story of how she sat on the bank. She was standing there, she had tea. My oldest brother, who was not even a year old. It was raining, it was midday, she said, and they jumped in the boat and pretty much took a punt. And, you know, there was shots fired all around her. She says she still remembers the sound of bullets piercing the water.
You know, you think, oh, you go to another country, you might be start a better life, you know? And want to help family, you know? That's my thinking, you know? And when I cross, it is scary, you know, because so many things, you couldn't get shot, you couldn't, you know, they couldn't shoot you on the, you know, something.
It's pretty overwhelming because, you know, she's told me all these stories and I've heard about them, and especially when I was younger, you know, when I was bad and she'd be telling me off, she'd say, you know, I carried you through the, you know, you'd do this and I carried you through the swamp, and it was like, oh, you know, so when you're young, you sort of just think it's just your mum telling you off, and it's just a bit of telling off banter. But coming here, it's pretty surreal, pretty overwhelming, you know. Like, feeling pretty emotional and that.
Yeah. You just can't fathom it. Like, I wouldn't. I think, you know, how old would she have been? Maybe 18 or 19 or somewhere along those kind of lines. And, you know, you think about us as Westerners, what we're getting up to when we're 18 and 19. The last thing that we're going to think about doing is crossing the Mekong with you know, bullets firing at us. You know, we're busy out there thinking about what club to go to next or something like that. And you know, rewind the clock 30 something years, and that's what our parents are going through.
I am very scared, I tell you, but I'm proud of that. I said, I step foot forward, I never look back. So I said, if I'm going to start, move forward. I can't move back. You know, even I beg or fought, my life gonna be, if I come back, they're gonna put me in the prison if they catch me. So if I move, if I go forward, I don't know what life gonna be, you know?
So when you got to Thailand, the Thai people look after you?
No. Like
refugee camp type thing. It's crazy to think that we just know Mum in New Zealand, you know, and she's got all this stuff behind her back here, so going to revisit it, it can only be good for us.
We didn't know anything about this. Mum sort of, you know, and she said she didn't want to make a big fuss out of it, but for me, it's good that the little bros get to hear it as well, you know, because, as she said that, you know, she's always told me the story, and I've always wanted to know about Mum because it's always been, you know, a part of your life that you only hear stories about, and you want to know about your mum and where you come from, and you sort of wonder about who you are, you know, everyone wonders who they are, so, yeah, it's pretty overwhelming.
Yeah, I just have so much appreciation, I guess respect for her, you know, to go through what she went through to, yeah, get herself to New Zealand in the first place because, yeah, we're here today to talk about it.
Glad you did it, Mum. Yeah, you did it. Look what you got now, hey? Hey.
We've arrived in Paksei. We're about to go check out the town, go have a look at some markets and that.
You reckon they'll give way to us at a pedestrian?
Let's chance it. Let's have a look. Go real slow. Nah, pedestrian crossing's been nothing new. We've just done out. We made our way down to the markets and come in here. The hustle's just, it's real, man.
Well, this is happening, all right.
Yeah. Everyone's just out here trying to earn a buck, and you can see by how much is going on, the way people are moving, how urgent people are. It's a place that's really happening, and this is their living.
That was crazy. Saw a lot of strange foods, and it was just chaos. It was just people everywhere, interesting smells everywhere, and it was just chaotic, like the most chaotic market ever. But really cool.
Somebody.
One like that. Do you have big one?
Me.
Big? Yeah. So here, what do we have here? This is a 4XL. 4XL for the big fella. Ooh, it's the Lao King. This is the fun part, fellas. How much you got?
100,000 kip.
Oh, they're savage. They're savages. This guy out here, for the sake of a dollar or two, he's just trying to make his way, and we've got our brothers down here trying to hustle him down, you know?
Bye, Bully.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Trying to earn a buck.
Yeah, but when I think about it, I reckon I could have got them lower. At the end of the day, you realise that you're only bartering over 80 cents or something like that, so it's like, oh, well. Oh, okay.
Throughout the markets, they've obviously got their food, and they had fish still alive just in this little tight bucket, straight out of the Mekong. So very fresh.
Mekong?
Yeah, Mekong.
We had some flies that came with some meat for sale. All their fruit looks really, really nice. See, what you gotta do is you gotta go low so you get the ones that haven't had the flies on them. Yeah, there you go. Come Tay. How much?
I think he's saying, give me your money.
Give it all. Oh. No. No. Oh, I just got owned.
How much did you give it?
20 bucks.
Did you give it 100,000?
100,000.
Oh,
boy. Shaun would have been better off going to Ponsonby Road to buy his grapes, so.
Mate, we're funding a living here, mate. These people are out here grinding. Nothing but love, auntie.
It's a quiet heart, like a car. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Mum's brought us back to this spot in Atapu to show and tell a story about her family and where she grew up.
So that there was just land that you guys had for ages.
Yeah, and then... you see 1, 2, 3, that's all my mum's. Coffee, land, clothes, salt, you know, all the grocery, everything. My mum and dad doing
it. You know, to feel that that's where it all began, you could feel that, you know, this area, this land is all pretty sacred and it's a very special place.
Just look at that.
This was her mum and dad's land, and they used to have these little pop-up shops, these little cafes, grocers, and all that, and they just used to sell out of there. Then you swing around to here, and the same, this was all land, and down the end here is a little river that she used to bolt to after school and go swimming, she was just saying, so this is sick, this is awesome.
Oh! Oh, Bob!
This has been one of the highlights of the trip for me. There's just been this elder, old-looking fellas just crossed the road. And Mum's seen him, and they've just pretty much come together. That's Mum's great-uncle that she hasn't seen in over 50 years. And he looked at her and goes, and he just went off. He just couldn't believe it.
He said, I still look so young with my dad.
Emotional, yes, and happy, yes, because happy I still see him alive, you know. That's thing, even many years, I lived that time about 50 years ago. That's the first time I went back, I still see him.
Top it off, the auntie, so his wife comes out, who Mum said looks so much like Mum's mum. And the pictures we've seen, we agree with her. She was going too. She was, all the emotion come on and you could see Mum. It was such an awesome moment. Really, really cool moment.
Yeah.
Goodbye.
Come to Vang Vieng for the day. Yeah, we're out here. It's quite a cool place to be. Actually, there's a lot more tourists around, so we're out here and we are doing it. We're gonna go tubing. This is very well renowned up here, so have to do it apparently. So we're out here.
Let's go.
You know, there's times where you sort of don't feel like you're moving and you're sort of real chilled out. And then there's times where you sort of hit the rapids and yeah, she gets a little crazy. We've come to this beautiful place here, the Tum Nong Caves. We had these headlights that did jack all, but luckily you're with a guide, so sort of just follow his footsteps. Yeah, some pretty awesome things to see in there. We've done a lot of learning, a lot of cultural experiences, so it's actually time to be tourists. I don't know how to say it. Hey, it'll be fun. This day trip up to Vang Vieng has been an absolute blast for us. It's been really cool to see Laos in a different light. It's certainly a day we won't forget. Tonight we're going for a family feed at my auntie's house in Svanakit. That's where my grandma lived. Pretty much every time my mum comes back to Laos, this is the first place she goes and stays. So for her, this is like coming home. You know, so I know it's a special place in her heart, so really looking forward to seeing what it's all about.
Hey,
arrived at my Auntie Noi's house and we hop out of the car straight away. We're all actually really excited to be here, and then Joe was just pretty much thrown into a feed.
Straight into it.
You've got a challenge on your hands, Mum.
They don't muck around, eh?
Sure.
Yeah?
This one went to the grandma's favourite place.
Why is that? What? While Joe was getting taken to the table, Mum actually came and grabbed me and took me over to this tree, which is just in the corner up there, and just sort of said to me that it was her mum's, you know, favourite place of the house.
So she spent a lot of time in
here. Yeah, yeah, she loved it. Mm.
Do you like coming back?
Oh, yeah, yeah, Mum. That's why Mum and Noi are so together.
Yeah.
Because our mum loves us.
Wow, and, this is awesome, yeah. Mum.
Our mum loves us.
Look at the feed.
Dumb, yeah, dumb. And Noi, make
everything. I sat down and I immediately pretty much saw my favourite Lao food. Everything that my mum's cooked for us back home over the years was literally on one table.
These spring rolls? Taste like my mum's. My mum makes it for us in New Zealand.
And we had everything from our spring rolls, sticky chicken, sticky rice, pho. Now they're wanting to know who cooked it better, so I don't want to answer that here. I'll tell you later.
Better, eh?
Shh, don't tell her. Mm. I've gone upstairs and in the space of a minute I've seen my granddad, my grandma and my great-granddad.
When grandpa died, Noi, 3 months old, when he died, he very young. Yeah. Like Mum said, he worked so many places, worked gold mine, brick wood, you know. So.
My granddad, he passed away when my mum was only one. Noi was, yeah, less. Only just born, really.
So this is Dad?
Dad, yeah.
You know, he worked a tough life. He worked in the mines, and he died young because of it. So, you know, my mum and her sisters didn't grow up knowing their dad.
Opening that door into the shrine, you know, you don't see that in many people's houses, are they like that? You know, I read this thing once, and it said that, you know, you die twice. You know, the first time you die is when your last breath leaves your body. The second time you die is when someone speaks your name for the last time.
That was deep, bro.
You're feeling that one?
Now, this trip for me has been a genuine dream come true. It's literally exceeded every expectation I thought it ever could.
If you could imagine seeing your mum for the first time with her family, for me it was just so happy, you know. It was soul food, you know, feeding the soul.
It's almost like it's a mum that we've never known, you know. She's a completely different person, and seeing her so happy, dancing around, singing the Lao songs.
I don't think my children know me at all. Know me, but they don't know me well, put this way, you know. But now when they came, they see their mom culture, they see how I am, they see all my family talking. I can see that my children being close to me and connect with me more.
Look what you got now, hey?
Obviously, just learning a whole bunch about mum and her side and has been really good for me. I'm a lot closer with Mum than I was before I left.
A huge turning point for me anyway and how I view my mum and just appreciate her that much more. So.
We all loved Dad to bits, and for Dad to come along and for even Mum to open her heart up to share this with Dad fully is, you know, it's been really special.
We're just looking at each other, pinching ourselves, saying, you know, this has finally happened. It's brought everyone together a lot closer than we were, just understanding this side of the story, really.
Sometimes you don't really learn about someone until they pass away. You know, you go to a funeral and you learn bits of someone's life that you didn't even know existed, and it's like, whoa, they did this, they did that, and it's not until then that, you know, people come together and, you know, you see family that you haven't even met for or seen in a long time, and you finally get together and you share, you know, the moment, the celebration of someone's life. You know, for me, it's like we've been able to come together in this moment and share my mum's life, so, while she's still here, so it's, yeah, it's been pretty awesome, bro.
So this morning, mum's come to me and pretty much said that she wants to move back. And obviously, mixed emotions about it, but at the end of the day, I've never seen mum as happy as what she is right now. Hey, look, I'm all for it. You know, I want her to be happy, and if anything, it gives us a good excuse to come back.
Funny, yeah, everyone's probably gonna look at this and see our family as one big happy family, you know, that it's just like, oh my God, how are they getting along so well? But at the moment, I can't argue, this is the happiest we've been as a family ever, and to be able to say that standing here in Laos, at my grandma's house, yeah, it's a surreal feeling, eh? So this is definitely something I'll never forget.
Gloves on, you feel like.